Hello and welcome back. In this lesson, we're going to take a little bit of a deeper dive into how information flows within a modular infrastructure in Terraform. So as you can see, we've got somewhat of a typical setup. We've got a root module, an image module that will create a Docker image, and a container module that will utilize this image to create a container. Now we've got a terraform.tfvars file here where we can define some of our variables. We've got variables.tf, main.tf where we're actually listing out our infrastructure, and outputs.tf where we can display outputs that we've deemed important. And of course, since this is modular, each module has generally the same files. Now, they could have a terraform.tfvars file, but we don't need one for this particular deployment. So let's take a look at how we're going to get an image name that we dictate from our terraform.tfvars file into our image module, then to our container module so it can deploy the container based on that image. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fire up my terminal here. As you can see, our budget has been running a little slim lately. Now, once our terminal is turned up, let's go ahead and define our image. Now, since Grafana is part of the official Docker registry, we don't need to add Grafana/Grafana, but you could if you needed to. But in this case, we're just going to specify Grafana as the image name. Now, once we've done that, we're going to run our Terraform apply, auto approve. And what we need to do next is basically initialize this image variable. So what this is doing is creating the image variable, defining its type, which is optional, but it does help a lot if you're working with a team. And then of course it could be defined here using a default, but in this case we have not done that. So what's happening is this terraform.tfvars file is specifying a definition for this image. Now, you could also use environment variables, or you could define it at the command line or from other locations, but right now we're using the terraform.tfvars file. So then we have our main.tf here. So what's happening is we've got this variable created and defined here. So what we're doing is we're creating essentially a new variable here, image in, and defining it as var.image. So image, as you can see, variable image is var.image, which equals Grafana. So this now is image in being defined as var.image, exactly the same way as we defined image in the terraform.tfvars file. So as you can see, that's in our module image section here of our main.tf. So that's referencing our image module. So what happens is next, we need to initialize that image in variable here in our variables.tf within the image module, the same way we did that with our root module. So once it does that, we can then pass over to our main.tf. So we've got a resource Docker image, and we're just calling it image. And the name, which is also the image name, is defined as var.imageIn. So this var.imageIn is now the same as Grafana, which is already passed through all of these files. So once we've done that, this main.tf, which is being called by the main.tf in the root module, will create our image. And then if we set up our outputs properly, we're going to have the latest ID of the image we just created. So this is our output file, output image out, value equals Docker image, image.latest. So now, image out is the output we need to access to get the ID required for our container module to deploy this container. So we pass this back to our main.tf, and we're just setting up another variable called image in, and we're defining that as module.image.imageout. So as you can see, it's the image module, so module.image.imageout, which is the output. And this output name is completely arbitrary. You could name it anything you want. So next, what we're doing is we're passing this image in variable to another initialized image in variable here within the container module, which then of course is used to define the image that we need to create our container. So once we've done that, as you can see, we have our cool little container deployed here. We set up another output, and this is just for our own purposes. This is so that we can see the name of all of the containers displayed on our screen after we run our apply. So, pass that back, and then run that through our root outputs.tf, output container out, value is module, so module.container.container out, just like so. So once we've done that, our apply can finish, and we have our outputs. And in this case, the name is Grafana container, which matches the name set here. So as you can see, we set the name as Grafana-container. Our output references that container.name and then displays it here. So that's basically in a nutshell how the modular system in Terraform works and how information flows through most deployments.